Well, Thursday night is music night, and if tonight's guests here at the desk appear familiar, it's because they are two of Australia's most acclaimed performers, but they're about to embark on a very different project involving one of music's most influential figures. David Bowie ranks as one of the most successful musicians of our time. His list of hits over the decades is extraordinary, with many artists listing him as their number one influence.
Check ignition and may God's love be with you.
Now, three of Australia's most acclaimed vocalists have teamed up to honour the man and his many personas with Ziggy, the songs of David Bowie. Those performers are Jeff Duff and Steve Balbi. Welcome, gentlemen. Mr. Bowie, a difficult and complex character to emulate. Let's start with the outfits. Looking outstanding here. How much effort goes into trying to, I suppose, recreate the character?
This is nothing, really, is it?
You know what? That tie, that's
this
a tie. Perfect knot.
Oh, yeah, we're talking about
this. I've been trying to do my tie like yours.
It only took me 45 hour. Minutes, this one.
Is it real, though?
It is real.
It's not an elastic.
No, I mean, it's not an elastic. It cuts off just here. Is that one real?
Yeah, of course.
Where'd you source the outfits from?
Yeah, you've got a special story about your suit, don't you?
Yes, this suit, believe it or not, I was a regular performer on Countdown during the 70s, and I had a new record out on Mushroom Records, and Michael Gudinski got really, really sick and tired of me wearing leotards and makeup and looking like a girl on Countdown. Mm. So he said, I'm sending you off to a tailor, Jeffrey, to get a suit made. So he sent me away, and this suit is the end result.
Very good.
And it still fits after 123 years.
Everyone needs a red suit. Can I ask about David Bowie? I was looking at YouTube before, Life on Mars, and a couple of comments from fans. This song changed my life. He's my hero and my God. A life without Bowie is a life not lived. There are so many people around the world who agree with that, don't they?
Yeah. I mean, he has an amazing fan base all over the world who have grown with him through the generations as well. So, you know, grandparents and their children and their children's children have all hooked onto Bowie, and it's ever growing.
Do you have to be a bit eccentric to play Bowie? You have to be, don't you? Surely.
I think you've got to be crazy to play any kind of music, really, for a living. But, Bowie was a real artist.
Yeah.
You know, he really pushed the boundaries, not only musically, recording-wise, and his look, so...
And with technology, too, he's you know, more advanced than any other performer as well.
I'm sure about crazy, but maybe a little left of centre.
Yeah.
How did this show come about, and how did you choose which songs to perform?
Well, we cover the whole gamut of Bowie from... Space Oddity was 69, wasn't it, 1969, right up until the mid-80s, because beyond the 80s, really, a lot of it wasn't quite audience-friendly, you know, he went off on these tangents, so right up to the period of Let's Dance, during the 80s. A lot of the stuff from the Ziggy Stardust album, which is, you know, probably the most famous of Bowie's albums. Mm.
So what can people expect from the show? It kicks off in just under 2 weeks.
It's really ecstatic, and it's very colourful, and we all really enjoy the material. Like everyone in the band, you know, Phil Sobrano, Jack Housden from the Bad Loves.
Bryden
Stokes. They're all just there because they really love the music, and it's just a great show. It's an honestly good show.
Steve, a lot of music fans will know you from Noiseworks. Bit of a change, Bowie Noiseworks, isn't it? But obviously you like a bit of everything.
Yeah, I'm a bit of a chameleon. I think I wanted to be an actor, really. It's nice to sort of let your hair down, get out front and...
Yeah.
There's a bit of Johnny Depp going on there tonight.
There is a bit of Johnny Depp. Pirates of the Caribbean.
So you're encouraging people who come along to the show to dress up and kind of get involved as well.
Yeah, if they can dress up, they'll get in free.
Really quickly, where did you get... You've sourced some astronaut outfits. Where did you get those?
I sent over to NASA. They arrived from NASA last week, and we shouldn't be mentioning this because the band don't realise that they'll be wearing them.
All right, we've spoiled the surprise.
You just let the cat out of the bag.
That's good. Well, we're hoping that we can redeem ourselves. You're going to perform for us a little bit later the Bowie classic, obviously, Space Odyssey. You're going to stick around and perform that for us?
Yeah. And we have to let you know that we're releasing quite a few extra tickets because it's almost sold out. So. Okay. Did you know that?
No, but I do now.
It certainly doesn't surprise us, gentlemen. So thank you very much, and best of luck with the show.
Cool. Thanks, thank you very much.
Thank you for your time.
Cheers, guys.